Diabetes is caused one by one a special organ in your body called the pancreas stops functioning and eventually just breaks down. Quick fact, did you know out of the 2 million plus diabetics in the world, only 8% of those diabetics are type 1? So when the pancreas breaks down, you can't control your blood sugar, and that's when we talk about highs and lows. Now I know some of you must be thinking, can't you just remove the pancreas? Well, the answer is no. Even though the pancreas is not functioning, you still need it in your body to live. The pancreas produces insulin, and you also need insulin to stay alive. For any food that you eat, a certain amount of insulin is necessary. Taking care of it means that if some sort of food is high in sugar, the insulin will make sure it doesn't make your blood sugar jump. If you have type 1 diabetes, you have to have a needle of insulin every time you eat something that has any amount of carbohydrates in it. To check your blood sugars, you need to prick your finger and put blood onto a blood test strip and wait 5 seconds, and then it will show you your blood level. I have done this many times and it just feels like a little pinch. Nothing to be afraid of. When you're old enough, you're able to get an insulin pump. A pump is used throughout the day when you eat food. It replaces your insulin needles. You input into the pump what you are eating, and then insulin will disperse through a needle into your body. Now the symptoms. Common diabetic symptoms are unusually high thirst and frequent urination. Both of those you can also get when you have high blood sugar. You have no energy at all, blurred vision, frequent or recurring infections, cuts and bruises that are slow to heal, and bruises on your hands and feet. Some of these symptoms are not that painful, so don't worry. If you have at least 3 of these symptoms, you should consult a doctor immediately. It might be just an allergic reaction, but it's better to be safe than sorry. Am I right? When you have a high blood sugar, the ordinary symptoms might be increased thirst, multiple trips to the washroom, migraines, trouble concentrating. Some of the symptoms of a low blood sugar are a lot of sweating, mainly on the back of the neck or hairline, shakiness, extreme hunger and stomach aches, and fast heartbeat and feeling anxious. Alright, now I'm going to tell you a short story of my connection to diabetes, my brother's story and his diagnosis. It all started with an ear infection that my little brother Zach had. We went to see multiple doctors and they just kept saying it's an ordinary ear infection, we'll just have to run its course, let the antibiotics do its job. But his symptoms got worse over the next couple days. He had no energy and was very late. We took him to 3 walking clinics, and every time they said the same darn thing, and it was just making my parents even more upset and worried because his hearing was changing. So, one night on July 10th, 2013, 1 week before his first birthday, my parents and I finally took him to the ER and through 4 hours of tests on Zach, waiting to see what the heck was going on, they finally broke the news that he had type 1 diabetes. The scariest part was when they said if we let him go for one more night, he would die. So the doctor said we had to rush him straight to the ER in Peterborough. Well, it was too late for me since I was only 8 years old, so I had to stay at my grandparents for a week. My brother had to get airlifted to SickKids, where he had to stay there for 3 days, and then had to get driven to the Aurelia Hospital, where he had to stay there for 7 days. So on July 17th, my brother's first birthday, my nana and papa and I drove up to see him in Aurelia. I almost cried when we found him sleeping in his hospital crib with tubes left, right, and center going all over him. We had a quick birthday party and then I had to go. Within 7 days, my brother was back at home and we had something we did not expect to be in our lives, diabetes. I had done some research to get my brother's diabetic footprint. Since he got diagnosed 3.5 years ago, he has lost 750 hours of sleep. He has had 7,507 finger pricks and has had 9,184 insulin injections. In my mind, he's the bravest little guy I know. I hope they can find him.